The year is 1861, and the Confederates have just constructed a military installation at a site called Fort Pillow and named it after General Gideon Johnson Pillow, a Tennessee native. Fort Pillow overlooked the Mississippi River and was an important part of the Confederate river defense system. It proved to be useful to defend Confederate ports for collecting and transporting resources. In 1862, the Union Army and Navy was able to siege Fort Pillow and used it to intercept and pass their own resources throughout the rivers. Fort Pillow stood on a high bluff and was protected by three entrenchment lines, which were arranged in a semicircle. That was then surrounded by a ditch, a classic fort system. In battle, the design of the fort did not allow defenders to fire upon approaching troops without mounting the top of the parapet, which subjected them to enemy fire. Because of the width of the parapet, operators of the six artillery pieces of the fort found it difficult to depress their barrels enough to fire on the attackers once they got close. This did make it easier to penetrate the fort as an attacker. The date is April 12th, 1864. The North and South are tense, as the American Civil War is at one of its peaks. Confederate men under the Major General Nathan Bedford Forrest have been employed in a month-long campaign to raid federal and Union fortifications using cavalry. Fort Pillow, which was earlier sieged by the Union 2 years earlier, had been an essential southern reinforcement structure on the Mississippi River. The massacre. Normally, when armies are far outnumbered, they surrender, right? Well, that's exactly what the Union troops did. They knew that they had no chance at winning or inflicting serious casualties due to the bad design of the fort for attacking the attackers and because they were far outnumbered. Still, the men inside the fort were serious and skillful in their strategy. After they raised the white surrender flag, Confederates began to raid the fort. Once Confederates realized that over half of the garrison was filled with black soldiers, the Confederates were enraged and began slaughtering all black soldiers and their officers. In most battles, the number of injured will outnumber the amount dead, as soldiers will not purposely try to make each and every person and make sure that they are killed, especially in the case of the American Civil War. However, in the Battle of Fort Pillow, over 50% of the soldiers were killed, with special casualties for the blacks. Though most of the Union garrison surrendered and thus should have been taken as prisoners of war, some 300 soldiers were killed, about half of them, and the majority of them were black. The Confederates had said that the black soldiers would be subject to death, however, they were not treating these black soldiers well. The Confederate refusal to treat these soldiers as traditional prisoners of war infuriated the North and led to the Union's refusal to participate in a prisoner exchange as well as agree on the other points of the Code of Conduct. Black soldiers had a major impact on the Civil War, especially aiding the Union to their victory. Quoting Frederick Douglass, "Once let the black man get a musket on his shoulder and bullets in his pocket, there is no power on earth that can deny that he has earned the right to citizenship." After the first battle of Fort Sumter at the start of the Civil War, free black men set off in a rush to enlist in the Union's military units. In order to prevent this, the Confederacy essentially put a death penalty on blacks joining the Union Army. However, brave black men still joined in order to fight for their freedom. It gave them a purpose in their life. One example of this was the 54th Massachusetts Regiment, which set an example for black soldiers all across the Union. Estimates say a total of over 178,000 African American men joined the Union Army. Now, back at the massacre of Fort Pillow, Confederate soldiers say that they had been firing in self-defense, while other survivors claim that soldiers massacred women and children as well, being shot and killed in cold blood. Some gruesome events were also reported, like men being nailed down to the ground and others being buried alive. Fort Pillow and numerous other battles in the Civil War prompted a rallying cry across the North to fight for black rights. Some accounts recall four extremely horrifying events for torture of black soldiers, which started propaganda from the North to vilify the South and the Confederacy. Civil War songs like the Union Dixie, etc. portray some of these themes. The slaughtering of black soldiers not only encouraged other blacks to fight harder and avenge their comrades, but encouraged people across the nation to stand up against the South and the Confederacy. Although Fort Pillow was a minor event that was not widely recognized across the nation at the time, it played a major role in the back end, introducing black rights activism and slightly tilted the tides of the war in the North's favor in regards to social viewpoints. As, in the words of Matt Bevin, while it may seem small, the ripple effects of small things is extraordinary.